क्यों लिंक क्यों नहीं दे रहे? लिंक नहीं है आपका? अच्छा एक मिनट, एक मिनट, एक मिनट, मैं देखता हूँ। मैं वो नहीं, वो नहीं, अभी दुनिया भेजा हूँ, देखता हूँ, भेज रहा हूँ। क्या प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है? आपका नंबर बताइए ना, क्या ए लिखे ना, नीट डॉट गूगल ए एम एच जी डैश के ई वी डी वी डी डैश क्यू टी डब्ल्यू टी डब्ल्यू डब्ल्यू आ गया, आ गया ना? ठीक है, उसको हमने भेज दिया। ये तो 97 494 3647 47 एक तो निगम आ गया, हो गया, ऐड हो गया। चलो वी कैन स्टार्ट। गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर,
गुड आफ्टरनून अजीत। आई एम ऑडिबल टू ऑल? हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल टू ऑल?
यस सर, यस सर,
यस सर,
दैट इज ओके, गुड। सो हैप्पी न्यू ईयर ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन।
Happy New Year, sir.
Happy New Year, sir.
Okay, now we can start today, na? So in the last class, we discussed about the chisels, I think. We have discussed in the chisel, different types of chisels we are used in the fitting shops as well as make a workshop also. Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that means we are already discussed about the chisels. That means that there is a different cutting tools we are discussed. So one of that cutting tools is called as a chisels. And we have classified the different chisels. Okay. That is a flat chisel.
cross cut chisels, any students which will have present?
I'll just show you that. Then half round chisel, diamond point chisel, and side chisel. So this we are already discussed. Now today we discuss the cutting tools. What are the different cutting tools we used in the workshop? So first, what is that actually? Cutting tools is cutting tools of the file. That means we have discussed about the file today. The file is also one of the cutting tools we use in the workshop. Okay. So this is also used mostly in the engineering workshop, because this is very important tools we are used in the workshop. Most of the cases when we remove the materials or you finishing the materials, then we are used in the files. Okay, and it is a hardened piece of hard grade steel which will be used. Okay, to say slanting rows of teeth. Okay, and there is so many parts in the file. I just show you that this is basically called as a handle. This is called as a handle part. Okay. Now after that we have that tang. So this is called as a tang. Tang is a pointed part. Okay, which fitted into the handle. So this part which will be fitted into the handle. Okay, and the last part which will be called as a point or tip. Okay. So this is the end part of the files which will be called it that, or it is called as a the ending opposite to the tang. Okay. And other parts which will be called, and this is called as a side of this file. So this is basically cutting edge of this body of this particular file, and this is the edge part. This to both side which will be edge there, but edge there is no any teeth which will be given. Okay, and the length of the file is start from here to here up to that. That means that length which will be start from the tip to the tang. Okay, so that is called as a length of the file. So that is the total length of the file is from tip to tang. Okay. So here is also just show you that this is this file which will we have put inside this that is the tang which will be put inside the handle. Okay, so this is called as a files also. Now we come to the next part, classification of files. Okay, the files are classified and names according to the three principal factors. That is, we have used the three principal conditions to classify the files. First is size. So size of a file based on the total cutting length. Okay, so we are already discussed that what is the total cutting length. So this is the total cutting length. So this is the file length which will we have the total cutting length from the tip to the tang. Okay, or point to the tang. This is the distance from the point or tip to the hill, or also called as that. The files for fine work. So that is actually not tang. So this is up to the hill of that tang part, which will be called this part. So that is actually basically up to that heel part. So that is called as the length of the file, or you called as the cutting edge of the file. Okay. So the files of the fine work, if you have a fine working conditions which will be used for that, then we use for the 100 to 200 millimeter of length. Okay. And file for heavier work we are used normally basically 200 to 450 millimeter of length. Okay. So that means when you classify according to the size, we have size basically classify one for the fine work and the heavier work. So fine work and the coarse work you have called it. Okay, so the fine, when you consider as a fine work, then it is the length which will basically varies from the 100 to 200 millimeter. Okay, but when you use for the heavier work and conditions, then it is normally length is very big, large as compared to the fine work, is around 200 to 450 millimeter. Okay, now the next part is cut-off teeth. The cut-off teeth is divided into two groups. That is called as a single cut and a double cut. On the single cut files, the teeth are cut parallel to the other cross across the files of an angle about 60 degrees. So this is actually basically that they call as a single cut file. What is that? This is the edges which will we have, and all the teeth of the file which will be 60 degrees to the edges. Okay. So that is called as a single cut file. Again, I told you that the single cut file, the teeth are cut parallel to the other across the files at an angle of about 60 degree to the center line of the file. Okay. Now we come to the double edge. So double cut files have two sets of teeth. So this is, we initially we have a 60 degree. This cut which will be initial cut which will be 60 degree. Then again we have a up cut which will be called as a 70 to 80 degree to the center line. So here I just show you 70 degree. So normally it is basically 70 to 80 degree, not I just write here. This is 70 to 80 degree for the upper cut of that. Okay, so that means this is called as a overcut and the upper cut, which will be have to form the double cut files. Okay, so that single cut and double cut files are for that. Again, we have further divided according to the coarseness and the spacing between the rows of the teeth. Okay, so according to that, we have classified. There are so many classifications which will be given. So according to the decreasing order of roughness you have considered, then it is a rough file, then bustard file. The third one will be called as a second cut file. Then fourth one is a smooth file. Then dead smooth file and the super smooth file. So these last three is a very smooth file. It's called as a very very high finish type of file which will be used. Now the rough file cut which will be used for soft metal. So the first one which will be have the rough file. So rough file are used for the cutting to the soft metal. They are often used for the trimming of the rough edge of a casting of softer metal. Okay, so that means when you have a casting and we have just trimming the surface of the body, then we have to use the rough file. Okay, the bustard is a standard cut used for the general shaping work. Okay, the second cut file is an excellent file for the harder metal and gives good finish for many pieces of fitting work. So that means this is the second cut file which will we have most of the times we are used for the finishing work of that. And if you have more finish is required, the requisite, this is the high grade of finish which will be required, then we are used for smoother files, then dead smooth file and the super smooth file. Okay, so this is also the according to the roughness of the file we have classified. There are six files which will we have used for the different condition which will be roughness which will be used for that. Okay, now the next which will be according to the sectional form or shape of that. So that means which will be file which will be classified according to the shape of. Okay, so we have a total 8 shape of files which will be used in the workshop or fitting shop also. So that is called as a flat file, then hand file, then third one is called as a square file, pillar file, round file, triangular file, half round file and the knife edge file. I'll told you individually. Okay, so that is first we come to that flat file. What is that? This is actually basically called as a flat file. So flat file is a taper in width and thickness. So this file actually some taper from starting from wheel into tip. Okay, so taper in width and thickness and one of the most commonly used file for general work. Okay, there always double cut on the face and single cut on the edge. So that means this face which will be have always in a double cut which will be have. And edges sometimes which will be used for the single cut. But this file is mostly used for the any kind of engineering works. So that is basically that is called as the engineer files. This called as the flat files. Okay. Now come to the second one, hand file. This file is parallel in its width. So width which will be have parallel to that. So this width both the cases which will be have. This is also called as a rectangular type of that. Okay. And this file is used for the finishing surfaces. Okay, it has one edge and therefore it is used where the flat files cannot be used. So that is the edge is only one. So here is one single edge which we have considered. And this is also double cut file. Okay, so that is also used for the most of the engineering work hand file. Okay. Now the next one is called as a square file. This file is a square in cross section, so that the sectional views which will be square based. Okay, I just show you that. So this is our sectional view is a square based. Yeah, and it is also double cut and taper towards the point. So some point taper which will be given towards the point. This is used for the filling square corners, enlarging square or rectangular opening as a QI. So this file is basically used for the working on the corners, then enlarging the rectangular size of a, if you have a rectangular size, suppose I just show you that, suppose this is our one of the workpiece. Okay, I just put it here as a suppose we have a hole of rectangular or a square size of holes, which will be have. And just we have put in here to finish off this particular edges. This particular edges, if they have a one to finish it, then we are used for the square type of files. Okay. Next, it will be coming out as a filler files. Now, this file is double cut. Okay. So, this is also basically that means the most of the files which will be have a double cut. Okay. And narrow and the rectangular section. This is also for the rectangular section which will be have. Okay. It has one safe edge and is used for narrow work such as QAs, slots, and the groups. So, if you want to cut the groups, then the cut the slots, then QAs, this type of file is normally used. This is called as a filler file. Okay. Now we come to the another type of file. It's called as a round file. So basically it is a shape is a round size. This is full round shape which will be given. So this is the cross-sectional view of this. So this file is type of files are round in cross-section. The whole file which will be have circular in the round. Okay. So this file is used for the filling curved surface and enlarging round holes and the forming fillets. So I just show you again that. So suppose this is a one of our workpiece, or this is your workpiece. So we just put it in a hole here, and we just enlarging this. First we have to put in a circular face. So we have just put in inside this a particular round files, and we have cut this part of that enlarged view which will be have required. So this file which is basically this is enlarge of this circular edge. Then we have sometimes which will be suppose this is a round square shape, and we put it in a circular shape. Just put it in this way, curvature of that. If you have put it in a curvature base, then we have to use for this particular file. Okay, so that is also is most of the cases we are used for this also in a round file. So if you have a circular base working any work which will be have the circular type of base, then we have used for this particular round type of file. Okay. Then triangular file. This file is taper, double cut, and shape is that of a equilateral triangle. The shape which will be basically in this type of that. I'll just show you that. This is the shape which will be have. So this type of cross-sectional shape which will be have in this particular type of file. So this is are used for the rectangular cut. So this file is this. Also use basically used for the rectangular cuts and filling corners less than 90 degrees. So if you have a not 90 degree, you have a filling. So this type of files which will be used. Okay. So triangular files is also used for the cut of any kind of less than 90 degree of corners which will be have. So suppose we have a this type of corners which will be have. Suppose this is a corners and we have just put it in here. We have a nest. Suppose this is this type of that is the shape which will we have. So each type of files which will be basically used in this particular cases. Here we just put this file here and just the shape which will we have finish or you have to cut it in this particular edges. So this type of triangular files is also most of the cases in a we have to cut in a triangular type of shape or rectangular slots which will be cut in this type of files. Okay. Now we have to cut in a half round file. So this type of file is not as a circular base, but it is basically if you have a circular type of that. I just show you the circle. I just this type of file here. It is not completely half circle. So sometimes it's a 1/3 of that circle. So this type of file is the most. I just show you that to add most this type of mostly in this type. This one. Okay, this type of. Part which will be have used. So this is the taper part also. This file is taper and double cut. The most of the files which will be have double cut, and the cross section is not as a half circle. So that the cross section is not half circle, but it is 1/3 of the circle. Okay. This file is used for round cuts and filling curved surfaces. So if you have a curved surfaces, then with this type of files is normally used. Okay. Curved surface, then round type of cuts. If you want, then you use this. Half round type of circle. Hey, round half round files. Okay. Now the last file which will be used we have for the knife edge type of file. Okay, this file is saved basically in a knife edge, so that is this type of safe which will be used for that. It is also have a double cut. Just show you that this is the double cut also here. Show you that this is the double cut which will be have this type of that. Okay, and the safe which will be have according to the knife of that particular surface. But it is used for the very narrow slot. If you use cut to narrow slots, grooves and notches, then we are used for the knife edge type of file. Okay, so this is whole about our files we are used in the fittings of all the workshops. Okay, so we can stop here. We continue in our fitting. Today we have completed the fitting. So Fayaz sir. Fayaz sir. Or Nijam.
Yes, sir.
You will continue.
Okay, sir.
Will you continue? Okay, okay. Okay.
Okay.
सर वो अभी हम लोग का जो वो कुछ ये बोर्ड का कुछ मीटिंग है अभी वो आ रहे उधर से तो हम लोग को इधर कुछ मीटिंग है अभी हम लोग का ये कुछ इंटरव्यू टाइप का कुछ होता है ना 10 मिनट के लिए
सभी एक साथ जा रहे हैं क्या
नहीं
तो ठीक है आप उसको ऑन कर दो ये तो है ना ठाकुर है ना ठाकुर है ना
ये सर सभी लोग सभी का ले रहा अरे ये सर आ गए
क्या ऑफिस में विजिट हो रहा है सर
तो क्या करेंगे आज 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 स्टॉप कर दें क्या
ओके सर वेट
शेयरिंग द वीडियो
शेयर द वीडियो
Keep this like this, parallel to the vice. Now I will erupt in filing operation.
তুমি এক কাম ওদেরকে 5 মিনিটের জন্য একটা মিটিং করছো ওদেরকে দেখছি তুমি একটু 5 মিনিট একটু চালাও আমি ওদেরকে ছেড়ে দিছি
ঠিক আছে हाँ 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 ठीक है उसको स्टॉप करो मैं उसको कंटिन्यू करता हूँ ओके उन लोग को ठीक है ठीक
है ओके सर
हाँ
लोग मोबाइल छोड़ के जा रहे सर
हाँ ठीक है So students, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So actually, sir, लोग का कुछ शायद workshop में कुछ discussion है HOD sir के साथ. So we can, so हम लोग कुछ थोड़ा बहुत discuss करते हैं. वो लोग आ जाएंगे 10 मिनट के अंदर. Okay. So anyone, any problem related to workshop? If you have any problem related to workshop, just tell me first. Anyone, any have any problem related to workshop? Or any queries about the workshop related to that? Now, what are the different types of hammer we are discuss? What are the different type of hammers we are discuss? Hello.
Sir, so 7 types.
What are that?
Sir, claw hammer, cross claw. Pin hammer, ball pin hammer, straight pin hammer, chipping hammer, soft hammer, sledge hammer.
Okay, that is okay. Good. Rohit Mukherjee, Rohit. Rohit? Rohit? Hello, Rohit. Rohit Mukherjee? Hello, Rohit Mukherjee?
Yes, sir.
Where do you use claw hammer? Where do you use claw hammer? And why it is called as a claw hammer? Why it is called? Anyone? Why it is called as a claw hammer? Rohit? Okay, anyone? I just... Obhishek?
Sir, to pull out the nails.
So pull out the nails. Only we yes, have sir. To pull out the nails, then we are used for claw hammer or any other... Any other hammers we also use to pull out the nails? Only claw hammer we are used or any other hammers we are also using? Hello. Abhishek?
Yes, sir.
So this is, we are only used for this only, this particular hammer or any other hammer we are also used for the pull out the nails?
So I think claw hammer is also only used to pull out the nails.
Okay, that's good. Now, Bikram Kumar Pandit. Bikram Kumar Pandit.
Yes, sir.
What is the difference? What is basic difference between the cross pin hammer and a straight pin hammer?
Sir, cross pin hammer, sir. Sir, similar ball pin hammer in shape?
No. It is not the same. Cross pin hammer and a straight pin hammer. What is that basic difference between these two, cross pin and the straight pin hammer?
Sir, it is a similar, sir, in shape and size.
Similar shape and size, not that. Kausik Sadhu.
Yes, sir.
You know that what is the basic difference between the cross pin hammer and the straight pin hammer? Because this, why I choose the hammer, basically hammer is used for the daily work. If you have you have any kind of homework, then you have to use for the different types of hammer. If you have use for the your particular jobs, then we are used for the hammer. So hammer is basically used for every field of that. So that's why I just choose today's that discussion about the hammers. Okay, because the chisel, then... saws, which will be have for a particular working condition. They are used for the specific purposes. But hammer, we are used for the daily uses. So that's why I just take you that what are the different different conditions that we are used for that particular hammer. So that is why you have to know that what is basically what is the difference of the different types of hammer which for a particular working condition. Okay, so that's why I just discussed about that, the cross pin hammer and the straight pin hammer. What is that? Anyone can?
Sir, cross pin hammer.
The basic difference between that. When suppose you have any particular job or work in your home, then which hammer you are basically used for, the cross pin hammer or a straight pin hammer? So that is actually basically you have to choose it very way. That this is very important part. That you are chosen as an engineer, you are chosen is an optimality. That you have choose is as a specific purposes, you have choose as a specific tools for that specific purpose. So that is actually basically you have to consider as a difference between the engineers and the normal as a normal persons of that. Okay, so what is that?
Sir,
why you choose the
wedge? एक में parallel रहता है और एक में perpendicular रहता है hammer के. And
hammer का एक side में parallel होता है, कौन वाला?
Straight वाला parallel होता है और cross वाला perpendicular होता है.
Cross वाला perpendicular होता है. तो perpendicular होने का क्या फायदा है और स्ट्रेट होने का क्या फायदा?
थोड़ा ओरिएंटेशन सर, थोड़ा ओरिएंटेशन चेंज होता है तो
दैट इज आई गेस सर. गो हैव यू सीन आवर व्हेन एनी टेंट पर्सन व्हिच विल बी पुट इन अ नेल ऑन द बम्बू, हैव यू सीन दैट? देन व्हिच टाइप्स ऑफ हैमर दे आर यूज्ड बेसिकली?
सर स्ट्रेट वेल
बॉल पिन हैमर, इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ बॉल पिन हैमर. It is called as a ball pin hammer. Anyone? What is the significance of ball? Hello.
Sir, round in backside.
Backside. What is that meaning? Backside.
Sir, one side is a bit pointed, sir, so that we can fix nails easily. Sir, to hit the nails in such small areas.
No, but it is a circular in face, some, na? If you have a circular face, then how to put in a nails on that? Because the upper face usually we have a circular. It's a ball type of that, up round of ball. So then why you, how to put the nails on the surface from that particular face surface faces? Hello. This side basically used for the chipping work. If we have any chipping work, then we are used for this particular pin. Okay. Or you have a suppose a rivet is a rivet there, and just put the rivet and in the wall or any two pieces of that you have to just use in this particular case.
That, sir, to ball pin hammer ko chipping hammer bhi bola ja sakta hai?
Haan, bole to. Ball pin hammer ke chipping hammer bhi bolte hain. Normally cases mein. Because this is the technical word, but if you have most of the working persons that they are normally know the what is the different classification, then they are normally called it that. Ball pin hammer sometimes is called as a chipping type of that we are used. That is called as a chipping hammer. Okay. Then we are already discussing so many times which will we have vices. Now, what are the different chisels we are used? What are the anyone? What are the different chisels? I just Soma Banerjee. What are the different chisels we are used? Soma. Hello. Saurabh Singh. हेलो हेलो हेलो
यस सर
व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट चिजल्स वी आर यूज
सर फाइव टाइप्स
आई डोंट नो यू आर नो आर नॉट
टू सर फ्लैट चिजल क्रॉस कट चिजल diamond chisel side chisel and half round chisel
okay anyone can told me that I was asking one thing Udayan Chaudhary hello शुभदीप मंड माझी शुभदीप माझी हॅलो हॅलो शुभदीप माझी हॅलो शुभदीप माझी हॅलो एनीवन कॅन टोल्ड मी दॅट व्हॉट इज द बेसिक डिफरन्स बिटवीन द आउटसाइड कॅलिपर अँड द इनसाइड कॅलिपर is that hello okay Orijit Bandopadhyay hello Subhadip
sir may I
no I think it's a Subhadip Maji I just asking you that Saurabh Singh. Hello. Saurabh Singh. Okay, Kanchan.
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me. Bolo.
Sir, please ask the question,
actually,
sir.
What is the basic difference between the outside caliper and the inside caliper?
Sir, outside caliper, sir, hum, sir, राउंड सर्कल का बाहर तरफ मेजर कर सकते हैं और इनसाइड कैलिपर के साथ सर अंदर का डिस्टेंस मेजर कर सकते
हैं नॉट क्लियर अगेन आई टोल्ड यू टोल्ड मी
सर यूजिंग आउटसाइड कैलिपर वी कैन मेजर द आउटसाइड लेंथ
outside dimension
of the metal of round metal and using the inside caliper we can measure the inner dimension of the round metal
okay sure anyone any difference
sir both are used to measure the diameter sir if there is a round object sir so like a sphere sir for that we use outer caliper to measure the diameter as it's like a hollow glass or something like that we have sir to measure the diameter internally we use the inner caliper
okay snehal sir ka sneha sir ka sorry sneha sir ka
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about that micrometer? Heard about the name micrometer?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Yes, sir.
What is that? Micrometer?
Sir, it's a type of screw gauge.
What is the U? Where do you use this one? This type of instrument.
Um,
Yura. Hello.
Yes, sir.
To you, to measure the?
Sir, to measure the thickness or diameter of microscopic objects.
Only the microscopic objects.
Sir, colloidal particles.
Colloidal particles, you have can measure the micrometer. Sure. Anyone? Yes, anyone? Sir. Anyone? Vikram Kumar Pandit. Vikram.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Have you know that?
No, sir.
Micrometer. Kaushik Sadhu, Kaushik Sadhu.
Yes, sir.
Have you know that? Micrometer, where you use the micrometer and how to use that?
No, sir.
We are already discussed about that, now, micrometer. Hello. I show you that again, if you have. I just show you. My skin is visible to all? Hello. My skin is visible?
No, sir.
Yes.
No, no sir.
No, no,
no, sir.
Okay, I just visible my skin first. This one. Now is it visible? It is visible to all? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now, anyone can tell me that. How to calculate this one? Least count. How to calculate this one? Anyone can tell me that, how to calculate this one? Least count. Hello. Kaushik or Kanchan? Anyone? Kaushik or Kanchan?
Sir. Sir, length. Of sir, pi via valves.
Where the pi via valves is there? There is no any.
Sir, once we rotate the screw, sir, the length, sir, that it moves, sir, that is 1 okay. millimeter or 0.5 millimeter divided by the number of segments it has, sir, like 50 or 100 or whatever.
That is good. So that is, but the this is point. What is that 0.5?
Sir, it's the minimum one, length, sir.
Minimum division, that is the minimum length is
not yes,
there. Minimum division of that particular. 0 to 5 is a millimeter. So each division is a 1 millimeter. Now, 0 to 1 millimeter, we have a last division, which will be 0.5 division. So that means when it is called as a main scale, we have a 0.5 division. And the total division of the circular scale, which will be have 50. Okay. So that is just going to count it here. That is a 45. 46, 47, 48, 49. So total division is equal to 50. So this is the line which will we have. 45, 46, 47, 48, 49 line. So this is the total division is equal to 50. So that is the circular division which will we have, maximum division which will we have 50. And 0.5 is the minimum line which will we have the vernier scale. Okay. So that is why it is called as a least count of that. Clear all of that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And again, this too very important because when you as a IT students, you have to measure the any kind of small devices. So you have to use for the micrometer, then vernier calipers also. So you have the vernier calipers. This is also used for the vernier calipers. Most of the times you have used for the checking the any dimension of that. You have internal dimension, you have to calculate the internal dimension, you have to calculate the external dimension, then you have
calculate the depth of the knob, any types of grooves. So you have to put the knobs inside that grooves, and you have to measure it at how much distance which we have. Okay, so these two instruments is very, very important for calculating or to check the dimension of any kind of body. Is if you have a small chips or you have a very large body. Okay, so I think, I don't know, they are not they are coming or not, but if you have, we have continue, or I just call it back, take down, look. Just wait for 2 minutes, okay? हाँ हो गया फायर, स्टार्ट कर दो तब. Have you check your speaker? The sound is not coming.
Okay, sir.
Hello.
You got a voice. हमें कोई याद ही नहीं रहता है. Okay, just wait few minutes. Students, can you tell me how fell can be specified?
Like this.
Fell? Yes, sir.
Ah, that is okay. It is okay.
Okay. To the voice. Student, this video visible. Good response. Students.
Now, I will erupting. Falling operation.
Is it visible, student?
Yes, sir. the video, continue.
Hello students. नहीं जा रहा है आगे, अब आगे भी नहीं जाएगा, कहाँ जा रहा है? Hello students.
Now I will also file this portion, students. So I have to keep like this. Now my part is already completed. Hey students, see, this is male part. Okay, now I'll. Students, please respond. What is the title of the job? Students, what is the title of the job? Abhijit Shah. Yes. Abhijit Shah, what is the title of the job?
Sir, to create male and female part from this from
this. Arjit, which part is this? Which is in my hand?
Sir, this is the male part.
Yes, what material is made of the workpiece?
Sir, some steel. For gods.
Material will be classified different categories, okay? That all material like rubber, wood, brass, copper, that are materials, not metal, okay, students? And this is metal. Metal are also divided into two groups, non-ferrous metal and ferrous metal. So this is ferrous metal, in which the iron is contained. Non-ferrous metal are brass, copper, zinc, that are non-ferrous metal. Okay, so this is also specified different categories like high speed steel, high carbon steel, stainless steel, mild steel. Okay, so this is MS. Christian, this is mild steel. You must remember it. Now, Abhijit, you can tell me. Abhijit?
Yes, sir.
कौन सा मटेरियल है ये?
सर माइल्ड स्टील.
माइल्ड स्टील, ठीक है?
यस सर.
याद रखो कि ये मटेरियल जो है, जो हम लोग जिसमें जॉब प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं, जितना भी मेटल है जो कटिंग हो रहा है, दैट इज माइल्ड स्टील. ठीक है, ये मैलेबल होता है और सॉफ्ट होता है, इसमें कटिंग एबिलिटी होता है. इस मेटल है जो कटिंग एबिलिटी नहीं होता है, ऐसे हम लोग हाई स्पीड स्टील को हैक्सो से नहीं काट सकते हैं, फाइल से नहीं फाइलिंग कर सकते हैं. ओके
ओके सर.
प्रिपेयर फीमेल पार्ट, सी दिस इज द सेम जॉब पीसेस. ओके, सेम प्रोसेस आई हैव टू एड अप. फर्स्ट आई हैव टू मेक इट 90 डिग्री बोथ साइड. Students, can you tell me what are the methods of filing? Students, give answer.
Sir, straight filing, cross filing, and draw filing.
Define what is straight filing. Define straight filing, students. What is straight filing? When will you adopt straight filing? Students,
sir, when we only have to file a particular area, sir, so we put we do the straight filing. Sir, in cross filing, sir, when we have to cover us a bit of a surface, then we do small filing, and draw filing is to completely make the surface flat, where we completely file the whole surface.
Good, Abhijit. Abhishek.
Yes, sir.
What material is made of file? Abhishek.
File.
Yes.
Sir, not remember.
Adrita Pathak. Adrita Pathak. Adrika Pathak, give response. Arjit Bandhupadhyay. Arjit.
Sir, steel.
What type of steel? I have already told you the classification of steel.
So stainless steel.
Okay, there are different types of steel.
Sir, stainless steel.
Stainless steel. Aritra Bosch. What material is made of file?
Sir, mild steel.
Wow. Mild steel can cut the metal. The...
Sorry, sir. Sir, I don't remember actually.
Listen, cutting material is harder than the material which will be cut. Okay. So this is hard. See, listen, hard material name. High speed steel, high carbon steel, stainless steel, tip tool bit. Sorry, not stainless steel. Tip tool bit, carbide tip tool bit. Okay. There are hard steel. So this is
hardened steel.
Okay. This is high carbon steel. Made is file is made of high carbon steel. Okay. Students, give response. What?
Please loudly.
Yes. Straight filing, cross filing, and draw filing. Okay. You have to remember it, okay? Don't forget it. Okay? See, I have make it 90 degree. Okay, students, I have make it 90 degree and I will make this side also 90 degree. Students, Vikram Kumar.
Yes, sir.
What is the name of device which is holding, which is used for holding the job?
Sir, bench vise, sir.
Yes. Can you tell me how will you specify bench vise?
Sir, first of all, sir, chipping, sir.
No, specification. This is not under specification. Chanchal
sir, Mandal? it is a part of touch or join each other in such a way that one will turn inside of another and one will slide upon another or the parts hold tightly together.
Specification. So, Vikram, this is not a specification, okay? Chanchal Mandal. Chanchal Mandal.
Yes, sir.
How will you specify bench vise?
Sir, bench vise commonly used in fitting shop for holding a variety of jobs.
I'm not asking their principle, okay? I am just asking their specification, okay?
Yes, sir.
Do you know about the specification?
No, sir.
Size, means size.
Sir, I can tell.
Yes, Abhijit.
Sir, width of the jaw, the distance between the jaws.
Very good. The distance between the two jaws.
2 years. Oh, very good. Joy Chakravarti.
Yes, sir.
What material is made of bench wise?
Bench wise. Cast iron.
Very good. Do you know the properties of cast iron?
No, sir.
You don't know? Kaushik Sadhu? Kaushik Sadhu?
Yes, sir.
What is the properties of cast iron? Nandini Paul. Nandini Paul.
Yes, sir.
What is the properties of cast iron? Do you know, Nandini?
I forgot.
Nandini, I'm asking again other question. What material is made of bench vise? Nandini Paul. Nandini Paul. Are you present, Nandini Paul?
Yes, sir.
What change you are? What material is made of bench vise? Hello. Ki material diye banano hoyeche bench vise ta? Nandini Paul, why you not responding? Rohit Mukherjee. Okay, see students.
See, before starting the finish, you have to make 90 degree both sides. Then you have to mark it. Now, again I will rub the chalk on the metal piece. Now, first time I will get the middle point with the help of Jenny Kaipa. Now, I will get the middle point with the help of steel wool. Okay, see. This is 54 mm length. Now, I'll take students. Some students are not responding, okay? Soumya Banerjee.
Yes, sir.
What material is made of steel?
Sir, could not hear, sir.
What material is made of steel rule? Have you heard the name of steel rule?
Yes, sir, but don't remember, sir.
What is the use of steel rule? Soumya, what is the use of steel rule?
Forgot, sir.
Huh?
सौरभ सिंह स्वामी को थोड़ा सा करके रखे हो भाई लोग बहुत ज्यादा है इसको। हाँ सौरभ सिंह आर यू लिसनिंग सौरभ सिंह शुभदीप माझी सबको नोट करे होगा कुछ स्टूडेंट्स पता नहीं रहता है कि नहीं तमन्ना परवीन व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ स्टील रूल स्टील रूल का क्या यूज है बोलो अरे स्केल जो चीज है वो स्टील रूल है इंजीनियरिंग में हम लोग इसको स्टील रूल बोलते हैं
सर टू पॉलिश द मेटल
तुम्ही तो किछु जानो ना तुम्ही स्टील रूल यूज ता बोलते पालो ना
सर
हां
सर टू मार्क एनी समथिंग ऑन द गिवन
पहले पूछने दो तमन्ना परवीन
यस सर
बोलो स्टील रूल का यूज क्या है बोलो यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द लेंथ डायमीटर थिकनेस कुछ भी तो हो सकता है ना कोई लेंथ नाप सकते हैं कौन सा मेटल का बना होता है स्टील रूलर तुम लोग क्लास में नहीं रहती हो तो फिर वाइवा में क्या होगा तुम लोगों का मार्क्स का क्या होगा हाँ इसी दरमियान एक वैभव भी हो जाएगा समझ गई ना जैसे ही फिटिंग खत्म हो तो वैभव लिया जाएगा सभी का इसलिए मैं रिपीट कर रहा हूँ बार बार कौन सा मटेरियल का बना होता है स्टील रूल
आयरन
देखियो प्रेशर कुकर भी आयरन रहता है सॉरी प्रेशर कुकर आयरन और मेटल दो तरह का होता है यानी उसको दो कैटेगरी में डिवाइड किया गया है एक फेरस मेटल एक नॉन फेरस मेटल समझ गए ना जब फेरस मेटल जितना भी आयरन रहता है सब में वो फेरस मेटल है और जो नॉन फेरस मेटल है जैसे कॉपर जिंक ये सब जो है एल्युमिनियम ये सब नॉन फेरस मेटल उसमें आयरन नहीं रहता अब वो आयरन को भी डिफरेंट कैटेगरी में डिवाइड किया गया है ऑलरेडी मैं कितना बार बोल चुका हूँ सभी को कोई काटता है तो कोई कटता है अभी जैसे हम लोगों का जॉब पीस है तो वो कटिंग कट रहा है लेकिन काटने वाला जो है वो भी आयरन है और एक को काट दे रहा है वो भी आयरन है कि नहीं जॉब दो दोनों है ना एक हार्डर है और एक सॉफ्ट है कि नहीं बोलो तमन्ना तब तो क्या दोनों एक ही सभी को मैं आयरन बोल दूंगा नहीं ना तो वो जो है अभी देखो एक ब्लेड है ब्लेड में शार्पनेस बहुत ज्यादा होता है और वो शार्पनेस कुछ देर तक का रहता भी है काटने के बाद इसी तरह छुरी है छुरी भी एक आयरन है ना वो हार्ड मेटल का रहता है उसको अगर एक टीन का बना दिया जाए तो वो शार्पनेस रहेगा ही नहीं वो धार खत्म हो जाएगा ठीक है तो ये जो स्टील रूल है वो स्टेनलेस स्टील का रहता है देखो इसमें रस्ट जल्दी नहीं पकड़ेगा इसकी एक प्रॉपर्टीज है जो रस्ट से प्रिवेंट करता है अब देखो जॉब पीस माइल स्टील का है उसमें रस्ट पकड़ लेता है ठीक है अच्छा ठीक है लास्ट क्वेश्चन तमन्ना व्हाट इज द लीस्ट काउंट ऑफ स्टील रूल इन मिलीमीटर में स्टील रूल का क्या लीस्ट काउंट है जल्दी तुम खाओ ना उसके बाद हम खाओ स्टूडेंट्स तो ना बोलो लिस्ट कौन समझ रही है ना मिनिमम डिस्टेंस जो मैं मेजर कर सकता हूँ जो पॉसिबल है मेजर करना वो कितना है स्टील रूल में ये सब नोट करके रखा करो भाई बाबा का भी ये सब क्वेश्चन है बोलो
आई थिंक पॉइंट वन
कितना बोलो फिर से बोलो.
0.1 mm
स्टील में 0.1 मेजर करना पॉसिबल नहीं है, ठीक है ना. 0.5 mm है. माइक्रोमीटर में 0.1 mm क्या 0.01 mm भी मेजर करना पॉसिबल है माइक्रोमीटर में, ठीक है. अगर मिलीमीटर में रहा तो ओके. सीधा वीडियो. टेन ट्वेंटी ट्वेंटी फाइव ट्वेंटी सिक्स ट्वेंटी सेवन ट्वेंटी सेवन सी. दिस इज द पॉइंट, मीटिंग पॉइंट. नाउ आई विल कीप द ट्राई स्क्वायर. आई लेव द ट्राई स्क्वायर लाइक दिस. ठाकुर क्लास है ना, खाना खाए थे. स्टूडेंट्स सी दिस इज मिडिल पॉइंट. नाउ सेम आई विल टेक 15 mm. आई विल टेक विद द हेल्प ऑफ जेनी कैलिपर. ओके सी दिस इज 15 mm ऑलरेडी टेकन. नाउ आई विल मार्क इट. See, Jenny caliper is used for marking parallel line from the edge of the workpiece. Okay, now I am making female part. See how I will mark it.
Now I will take 15 mm from the middle. See, I am taking 15 mm from the middle. मेल होगा ना.
यस
ऑन द टॉप साइड. स्टूडेंट 10 5 एंड दिस साइड 10 5 15. सी देयर आर टू पॉइंट्स. आई विल टेक दिस टू पॉइंट्स. These points and these points. Okay, students, see. Students, are you seeing this? This is the our layout. Now I will mark like this. See, now I have to meet this point and this point. Okay. This point. And this point. Student, see. Yes, students. Now, what I will do? Students, what will I do? What shall I do now? Students. Can you give me answer? Is it permanent marking, students, or not?
Given, sir.
No, sir.
Then?
No, sir.
What?
So we have to make permanent marking.
Oh. What we have to use?
Punch
and hammer and anvil. Okay. Now see. Now I'll cut it. So for cutting it, I have to keep it 90 degree, okay? See, how will you measure it 90 degree? I have to measure it like this. Okay, see, this is 90 degree. And now I'll start the cutting. Like so. Before starting the cutting, I have to keep the hacksaw outside the cutting. Adapt the same process. Questions? Now I am cutting other side. And make it smooth. And also I have filing this portion. Keep it parallel to the bench vise. Okay, students. See, your job is completed now. Filing is. Now I'll.
This is drilling machine.
Now, see, students. See, students, I have to drill these portions. Students, I have to punch before drilling. Okay, see, this is the point where I will drill. So I am punching in this person. Okay, this is used for guiding the drill bit. Students, see, I am conducting drilling operation. I am using coolant for cooling the jaw or drill bit. Okay, students, I have made the drilling operation. See, this is drilling operation. Actually, this is tap drill size. Okay, now I'll make a thread in this drill size.
Okay, this is a part of drill machine. Part of drill machine, like drill chuck, sleeve. Okay. Next one is drill bit, metal material, high speed steel, and angle of drill bit 118 degree. Okay. This is a double multi point cutting tool. Okay. This is that vise and hold the job, and this is that table, movable table. Okay. Movable table. Okay. Backside is motor, three phase induction motor. Okay. Next operation is after drilling, tapping operation. Okay.
Thread cutting, I am showing you this tap. This is a tap made of high speed steel. There are three pieces in one set: tapper tap, intermediate tap, and bottoming tap. Okay. We will start with this tap, which is called tapper tap, and then I will use intermediate tap, and after that I have to use finisher tap or bottoming tap. Okay, now I have already made a drill. Actually, I am not telling you about it, that tap drill size. Okay, tap drill size. Tap drill size means the size of the drill will be less than tap size. Means T means tap. This size, this is half inch, okay, 12.57 mm, and the formula of tap drill size is P minus 2DP. Okay, students, this is the formula of tap drill size. When I will calculate this formula, then I will get 10.7 millimeter. Okay, tap size is 12.7 mm, and 2 and D equal to 0.6 4 mm, and P equal to 1.5 mm. Okay, then when you will calculate this, then you will get 10.7 mm approx. Okay, now I have already made this drill size, and I am starting that thread cutting. This is a tap used for cut internal thread. Okay, tap is used for cutting internal thread, and this one is tap range. Okay, students, see, before starting, I have to use the oil. This is mobile, so that the
will not freeze.
Okay, students, see. For cutting the thread, I have to rotate clockwise direction, and for cutting the chip, we have to rotate anti-clockwise direction, okay? Okay, students. There is no need to use the bottoming tap. Intermediate bottoming tap. Last finishing. Sir, I am using the finishing last finisher tap. This is also called bottoming tap. Okay, this is final threading.
Students, are you seeing these operations?
Students.
Yes, sir.
What is the name of this operation?
There's thread cutting.
Thread cutting. What type of tools I am using? Students, Abhijit?
Sir, tap.
Yes.
Sir, arrange and say that taps are of three types. Sir, yes. One finishing one and one middle one, and sir, one the first one I named, I didn't. Nicely.
Okay, I am telling you. So there are three taps in one set. Okay. That are first is taper tap. There are 1 to 10 thread will be taper. It depend the roughness of the thread. If the thread will be rough, then the distance will more than 8 mm. Okay. If the fine thread, that will be 1 to 8 mm, will be in taper. Okay, that is called taper tap. And second is intermediate tap. Okay, and the third is bottoming tap or finisher. Okay, Vijit?
Yes, sir.
Okay, na, to kon kon sa naam bataya main bolo to?
Sir, taper tap, intermediate tap, and finisher tap or bottom tap.
Okay, theek hai. What material is made of tap?
Sir, may I? Sir, highly steel.
What? Repeat.
Sir, highly steel.
No. Kaushik? Kaushik Sadhu?
Yes, sir.
What material do you make?
Sir, high carbon steel?
No. Manav Bhattachary? Manav?
Sir, high speed steel or something?
High speed steel. So, Abhijit, you don't want to say anything. You don't want to say anything.
नहीं सर, आप पूछ रहे थे तो हम रुके हुए थे सर.
नहीं, हम दूसरा से पूछा, इसीलिए तो तुमसे नहीं पूछा. अरिजीत बंदोपाध्याय, आर यू अवेलेबल? अरिजीत बंदोपाध्याय, अजीत, अरित्रा बॉस, अरित्रा बॉस, विक्रम कुमार,
तुम लोगों को देखो मार्क्स काट देंगे, इसमें हम मार्क्स परफॉर्मेंस मार्क्स दे रहे हैं, समझ गए? तो जो रिस्पॉन्स नहीं देगा उसका मार्क्स मैं काट लूंगा।
सर आई डोंट हैव माय ईयरफोन सर।
ठीक है, हो सकता है, लेकिन फिर भी
माइक्रोफोन इज नॉट वर्किंग।
अभी सुन रहे हो ना तुम लोग, जिससे जिससे रिस्पॉन्स पूछूंगा वो रिस्पॉन्स दोगे। ओके अर्थव बंदोपाध्याय, नेम द ऑपरेशन विच इज परफॉर्म बिफोर टेपिंग।
सर व्हाट सर?
नेम द ऑपरेशन विच हैज बीन परफॉर्म बिफोर टेपिंग। अभी मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, कौन सा ऑपरेशन कर रहा हूँ? ये वाला कौन सा ऑपरेशन है? देखो ये वाला, बोलो, पता है? पूरा वीडियो देख रहे थे ना
सब, देख रहे थे पर सर टर्म याद नहीं है।
टर्म याद नहीं है, तुम लोग रहोगे तब ना क्लास पे?
क्लास में ही रहते हैं।
रहते हो, देखो अभी तुमको दिखा रहे हैं। अभिजीत कौन सा ऑपरेशन है ये वाला?
सर ये टैपिंग है, इससे पहले ड्रिलिंग था।
सुन लिए? देखो दोनों बता दिया, जो मैं तुमसे पूछना चाह रहा था वो दोनों बता दिया। इसका मतलब है कि तुम मस्जिद में रहता है। अरित्रा बॉस
यस सर
डिफरेंस बिटवीन ड्रिलिंग एंड बोरिंग। आवाज नहीं आ रही है इधर।
हेलो।
हाँ डिफरेंस
सर, आई हियर यू।
अच्छा
हेलो,
यू आर नॉट
ऑडिबल। यस सर, कैन यू रिपीट द क्वेश्चन? सर योर क्वेश्चन सर, कैन यू रिपीट द क्वेश्चन?
ओके, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ड्रिलिंग एंड बोरिंग? Difference
sir, boring. No, no sir.
Vikram Kumar.
Yes sir.
Drilling or boring में क्या difference है?
Sir boring sir नहीं जानते हैं।
बोरिंग नहीं जानते हो, और ड्रिलिंग? चलो ड्रिलिंग का डेफिनेशन बोलो
सर। वो सर मेजर करके सर उसके बाद सर उसे ड्रिल किया जाता है।
तो ड्रिलिंग का डेफिनेशन बोलो, ड्रिलिंग में क्या कर रहे हैं हम? क्या कोई घर बना रहा हूँ या फिर कोई मेटल प्रिपेयर कर रहा हूँ, क्या तैयार कर रहा हूँ?
सर एट फर्स्ट सर मेटल में मार्क करते हैं, उसके बाद उस पर ड्रिल किया जाता है।
तो ड्रिल का क्या है पर्पस? ड्रिलिंग का पर्पस क्या है? जब हम ड्रिलिंग करें तो उसमें क्या पेयर हो रहा है, उसमें कुछ क्रिएट हो रहा है?
यस सर, होल सर।
तब तो ड्रिलिंग इज अ प्रोसेस टू मेक अ होल एंड बोरिंग इज अ प्रोसेस टू एनलार्ज द प्रीवियस होल। ठीक है, पहले से जो होल किया हुआ रहता है उस होल को जो है हम लोग इनलार्ज करते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड बोरिंग। जैसे तुम्हारा सिलेंडर देखे हो, बाइक का सिलेंडर, इंजन जो रहता है उसमें सिलेंडर रहता है, ठीक है ना?
यस सर।
हेड सिलेंडर, तो सिलेंडर में पिस्टन जो है स्लाइड करता है। जब गाड़ी धुआं करने लगता है या फिर ज्यादा तेल का कंज्यूम होता है तो समझ लो कि वो पिस्टन जो है, सिलेंडर जो है वो उसका डायमीटर बढ़ गया है। ठीक है, ये स्क्रैच आ गया, इसीलिए उससे जो है धुआं होता है या फिर ज्यादा पेट्रोल कंज्यूम करता है। तो उसको दोबारा जो है बोरिंग किया जाता है, ओवरसाइज का पिस्टन लगाया जाता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड बोरिंग। ओके, इनलार्ज द प्रीवियस होल, दैट्स कॉल्ड बोरिंग। ठीक है, समझ में आया?
यस सर
टीबी वाल वाला बोरिंग मत समझो ठीक है ना ठीक है स्टूडेंट सी द वीडियो स्टूडेंट सी क्लासेस Students, this is already completed our job. Okay.
Okay, student. Male and female section. Job number one has been completed. Okay. This is the thread.
See, okay. This is the, I am already making this is thread. Okay, internal thread. The tab is used for cutting internal thread. I am using tab for cutting this thread. Okay, students. So I am finishing today class now.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, students. Your both parts has been completed. Now, Maji sir,
okay, Maji sir.
Now, students, Abhijit.
Yes, sir.
Job समझ में आया?
हाँ, sir.
कुछ question है?
नहीं, sir.
कुछ भी पूछना है?
नहीं, नहीं, sir. Easy.
अभिषेक.
Yes, sir.
कोई question?
नहीं, sir. समझ में आएगा.
समझ में आएगा. अच्छा बोलो तो अभिषेक. What is the difference between अभिषेक? इसको ऑन करो अपना
यस सर
बोलो तो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इंच एंड मिलीमीटर जैसे इंच और मिलीमीटर में क्या डिफरेंस है बोलो तो
इंच और
हां
सर ये डिफरेंट यूनिट है मेजर करने का सर इंच और मिलीमीटर
क्या डिफरेंस है यूनिट का हां और कुछ है भाई साहब एक इंच बराबर कितना मिलीमीटर होता है
एक इंच
बराबर एक इंच में कितना मिलीमीटर होता है अभी स्केल को देखो तुम लोग और किए हो जो स्केल यूज करते थे क्लास में अभी इंजीनियरिंग ड्राइंग में स्केल यूज करोगे कितना है एक इंच बराबर कितना मिलीमीटर है देखो अरिजीत बताएगा
सर 25 मिलीमीटर
25.4
मतलब है कि तुम लोगों ने श्योर देखा है नेट पे अरिजीत सही बोलोगे गलत बोला मैं अरिजीत
सर कैलकुलेटर का कन्वर्टर यूज किया
अच्छा अच्छा कैलकुलेटर कन्वर्टर में किया ठीक है 25.4 mm इक्वल टू 1 इंच ठीक है माइक्रोमीटर का लीस्ट कौन कितना है मिलीमीटर में अरिजीत
सर
माइक्रोमीटर का लीस्ट कौन
माइक्रोमीटर का
हाँ लीस्ट कौन मिनिमम डिस्टेंस अब मैं बताया भी था इसी क्लास में ठीक है तमन्ना से क्वेश्चन किया था मैंने वो नहीं बता पाई तो फिर उसके बारे में बताया याद है नहीं याद है
अभी देखो मैं फिर जा रहा हूँ तमन्ना के पास. तमन्ना तमन्ना हेलो तमन्ना परवीन
सर 0.01 है क्या?
0.01 ही है. ठीक है, नाउ गिव योर अटेंडेंस. हाउ आर यू गिविंग योर अटेंडेंस? हेलो गूगल क्लासरूम अजीत, अटेंडेंस कैसे दे रहे हो गूगल क्लासरूम में?
नो सर.
Sir, not sure. You are calling the names
sir,
and
sir,
you are
sir,
telling yes sir, yes sir.
माजी सर शेयर नहीं कर रहे हैं?
नहीं सर, सर अटेंडेंस ही यही क्लासरूम में ही ले ले रहे हैं अभी. एंड में सर नाम बुलाते हैं, अटेंडेंस ले लेते हैं.
नहीं यहाँ तो मैं हम लोग ले ही रहा हूँ. ठीक है, गूगल क्लासरूम में भी दिया जा रहा है, वही पूछ रहा हूँ मैं.
नहीं नहीं गूगल क्लासरूम में नहीं.
ठीक है, तो अब अटेंडेंस लिया जाएगा. ठीक है, सब अपने चैट बॉक्स में, और फिर हम कॉल करेंगे जो जो अटेंडेंस देगा उन लोगों को कॉल करेंगे.
वन बाय वन सेंड योर अटेंडेंस इन चैट बॉक्स. ओके
ठीक है, चलो इन्फो चैट बॉक्स में अटेंडेंस हो तुम लोग, हम कॉल करेंगे, उसके बाद देख लेंगे जो जो दे रहा है. चलो लिखो तो नाम. नाम है ना? नहीं नहीं लिखो ना, फिर जल्दी हो जाएगा ना. कहते ना
चैट बॉक्स में, उसको बोल दिया चैट बॉक्स में देगा, लिख कर जाएगा. आप नेक्स्ट के लिए तैयारी कीजिए.
बस बस हमको नहीं पता, वो तो वही भेजेगा. निखिल सर का बोल लिंक भेजेगा.
हेलो सर, माय रोल 8, कैन यू मेक मी प्रेजेंट? नेटवर्क इशू, माय चैट बॉक्स इज नॉट विजिबल.
ओके, टेल योर नेम एंड रोल नंबर. लिंक तो जीएस को पूछ ले.
सर अरित्र बोस, रोल नंबर 8.
अरित्र बोस, रोल नंबर 8.
यस सर.
तो बस रोल नंबर 8. ओके
सर,
रोल नंबर 26 इन लोग नहीं किए थे हम लोग. दूसरा नहीं रहेगा तो आराम हो जाएगा ना. ओके पढ़िए, प्रणय गुप्ता नंबर 26.
और तुम देख ही लो तब. ओके हाँ हाँ ठीक ठीक. ओके स्टूडेंट, दोज हु हैव गिवन द अटेंडेंस दे कैन लीव.